I'm Terri Meyer, and today you're joining me on my Plein Air channel, and we're going to be painting the Mohican Covered Bridge. It's in Mohican State Park, and I'm going to walk around and look at different angles of the bridge, which I'm going to show you here in a few moments, and then we'll decide which view we want to paint today, and I'm going to set up my easel, do a thumbnail sketch, and we'll get started in the process. Look forward to having you join me. I've done a thumbnail sketch of the angle that I'm going to paint the Mohican Bridge, and I'm just getting ready to transfer that to my pastel paper, and then we'll get back to the easel and get started on the painting process. I've got the drawing transferred to a piece of pastel mat, and I just used a pencil to do it. First thing that I'm going to do is I'm going to probably do an underpainting on this one because there's so much green in this, and so I want to tone the green down by probably putting some oranges and purples in the background. Through here, this is a river that runs under the bridge, and the sky today is fairly cloudy, so there's not a lot of variation in the color. It's just kind of a very light gray. So with that being said, I'm ready to get started. So I'm just going to start with some orange. And I'm going to put some purple. And I'm just going to get a little crazy. Sometimes crazy is good. You never know what's going to happen. And sometimes the hardest part is just getting started, getting those creative juices flowing. And it's such a beautiful day here. I haven't been to this bridge in years. When my husband and I were first dating, we used to come here and do the hiking trails. But you know how life gets in the way and you quit doing things like that. So I'm just so delighted to be here in the outdoors, in the fresh air, just loving it. And the reason that I'm using the oranges and the reds, it's the complementary color to green, so it will help tone it down. And then this is a lighter color, so I'm going to use pink there. Okay, just add a little pink up in there because it's closer to the sky. So that's kind of interesting. Okay, now I'm using an alcohol mixture, just alcohol, and I'm going to use a small brush. And another thing that I'm going to do is I'm going to put some of this color in here as well. Now the roof is this. It's at an angle, if you notice the perspective is going back. The roof is reflecting the sky, so it's very light. Now there's also, I'm going to put some pink here because this is grass. I'm going to pull out my colors that I'm using, and I'm going to put them on my foam palette next to my easel. Okay, and this is very dark under here because it's in shadow. I'm just going to take some dark blue. And I'm going to take a dark purple, too. And this is kind of creating a blueprint for my painting. And then I'm going to, this is the bank of the river, so I'm going to make that kind of dark as well. And then I'm going to add pink through here too, pink and orange, because the, no, I'm sorry, that's wrong, this is dark, this is in shadow, so I'm going to just put that blue through here. And this is all in shadow as well. And then top part of this is in shadow. And then the trees are shining through that area. And we're going to put a little bit more of that pink through here as well. And through here. And now I'm going to get my alcohol. And I have, this is what I use. Yeah. Salad dressing container. And then I use a little, this is a watercolor cup, it's a travel cup for painting. And so I'm just going to put a little, you don't need a whole lot, I'm just going to put a little bit. So that's probably enough. I don't know if you can see that in there. Not a whole lot. Drips down, that's okay. This is the messy phase. Which gets you started. It takes away that fear, like, oh my gosh, is this, it's gonna work out? How's this gonna turn out? You just go with it. And the reason that I chose this angle is there's a lot of green around the covered bridge. And if I took some pictures from the front and you don't see any sky, This is about the only angle that I was able to get some sky in the painting, and I just thought it was a nicer composition than just the front of the covered bridge with no sky and just a lot of greenery around it. Plus you get a nice perspective where on the frontal view you don't get that. So I'm going to go ahead and finish this here and give it about 5 minutes to dry, and then I will get back to developing the painting. And I like to start, well, first of all, I like to start with the drawing to make my road map, and then I like to kind of start at the top and work my way down. So typically I start with the sky. And so this one, I'm going to do sky, I'm going to do the background, and then I'm going to leave the covered bridge as the last aspect. Okay, so I have the underpainting done. Okay, I'm going to turn the video off just for a few moments, and I'll be back with you in 5 minutes. Okay, the alcohol has dried, and now I have a nice blueprint for my painting. So I'm trying to decide if I'm going to go with a gray sky or if I'm going to go with more of a blue sky. Because, you know, you're the painter, you can make those decisions. So I think I'm going to go with more of a blue sky just because it's happier. Gray is kind of somber, sometimes depressing here in Ohio, so I'm opting for something a little more cheery in my painting. I'm not sure I like that color either, but I got it out. Let's see here. A lot of times I like to use pink in my skies because I always see a lot of pink near the horizon. So I'm going to put some of that pink in there. And then I'll blend it together. Pink is happier than gray, for sure. Now, let me see this color that I'm using. And I use this color as well, but it's more of a gray-green, and I don't really like it that well. So this is the pink color that I used. And I think that I want to go with kind of a transition blue. I'm not sure if this is... That's better. Yeah, it's not as gray as that other one. So I'm just going to add a little bit of that to the top of the pink. And then I'm going to take my fingers and I'm going to blend that. It actually looks like I've got some clouds in there, which, you know what, I can put some clouds in there. I don't have to make it one color. So, as you evolve in your painting, sometimes you'll have things that happen that just say, you know what, I'm going to go with that. Like, I'm liking this over in here. So I'm thinking, I might add some more pink in there. I like that. I like that transition, that it's not a smooth transition. I like that a lot. So I'm going to go with that. And I like that secondary blue that I picked. It gives the scenery more life than what I'm seeing here. Okay, and I always use this blue, and I just love this color. It's kind of, I guess it's kind of an aqua, no, it's a cerulean blue. And my apologies, I don't know the pastel color because I have so many of them that have just gotten combined over the years. I don't know what brands they are or anything. Okay, now that I got the sky done, I'm happy with that. I'm going to leave it. I'm not going to fuss over it anymore. And now I'm going to go into the background. And that's too green. Gotta find, there's a lot of blue in the background, in the trees, but I don't want to get it too dark. So I think this is probably the blue that I'm going to be using, especially near the top as it transitions into the sky. And let's see here. Gotta find the right greens, and sometimes that's a challenge. That one's too light. I'm gonna go with something darker. Maybe, yeah, around this color here. And there's different shades of green. That's not it. This one. And again, I'm just kind of scruffing it in. And I like to use a blending stick when I... when after I get the colors laid in to fine-tune it. Adding a little bit more blue. Tops of the blue as it interacts with this. Tops of the tree line as it interacts with the sky becomes a little bit more blue. And I'm going to go some areas that are darker green. That's probably about the same color. I'm going to go what I'm looking for. So I have all three of these colors in my hand. Just kind of going back and forth. And then I'll layer over them here after I develop it a little bit more. And too. This is more of a gray because this tree line's a little further back, so I'm gonna make that more of a gray. Gray green. And then I'm going to take, this is my blending stick that I use. It's well used. I have a lot of these, so when I get too dirty, I just change them out. I'm going to put a lighter green here because this comes forward. I'm going to stick that in there. Okay, so what I'm going to do first of all, that's the color I'm looking for. And the blue green. And then I think I'm gonna add some gray in here. I don't want it to have too much color in the background because that's gonna detract from the foreground. And as your eye travels through the distance of the atmosphere, the colors become more muted. So if you put too much color in it, you're going to lose your aerial perspective. I'm going to put, this is just a charcoal gray. I'm going to work that in there. That's going to show the shadows within the background on the trees as well, without adding chroma color to pull the eye or to pull the scenery forward. Now, you don't want to have hard edges on your foliage in the background. Again, hard edges bring the eye forward or bring the object forward. So you want to keep those things in the distance very soft and blurry. And you want to vary your tree line as well. You don't want everything going across at the same level. You want to give it a rhythm. You want to think of painting kind of like music. You don't want to keep playing the same note over and over again. Otherwise, that becomes a very boring music composition or song. So it's up to you to take the artistic liberties by changing things to make it more appealing to the eye. Now, the focus, obviously, of this painting is the covered bridge. So the trees are just a backdrop supporting the covered bridge. Now, for me, painting grounds me. Helps my mood. If I'm feeling low and I paint, it changes the way I feel. And I don't know why that is. It's therapy for me. I just love it. I guess whatever is bothering me goes away because I'm not thinking about it. I'm thinking about my painting and I'm more in touch with nature. Spiritually and more in touch. I feel that the creative process is using me, or they're using me to be a vessel for the entire creative process. Isn't that how life is? We're used to expand life. You know, even though this is just a very simple painting, it still is a creation. I'm adding that gray because it's a little maybe too bright. Graying it down. Okay, now I'm just going to put some, oops, that's kind of hints of branches in here. That's a tree that comes up. Okay, and I'm going to take a break. I'm going to step back and look at it. Okay, continuing to move forward. I'm going to start working on the bridge. And I've decided to use this soft pink as my roof color. once again, using my blending stick to kind of clean up the edges. Now, I'm going to get my pastel pencils. Because my pastel chalk is a little too chunky to get to some of the delicate areas. And since I paint rather small, this is only 11 and 3/4 by 4 and 3/4. I need some smaller tools to get into those areas. So, first of all, I'm going to add a dark line showing that the roof line is here. And I'm going to soften again just back here. It is in a distance, so the further it is in the distance, definitely the more I want that line to be blurred. And just clean this edge up a little bit over here. This line right here. And I'm making these areas of the painting sharper. That will bring this forward. It is in the foreground. It is the star of the show. And so that's what I want to portray. And then I'm going to do a cast shadow underneath this roof line. I'm going to take my chunkier piece of pastel and I'm going to lay that in. And there is a highlight on this edge. Thank you.